Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Supraja from Saptagiri College of Engineering, Bangalore. I'll be doing a presentation on metabolomics in methanol toxicity. So what is metabolomics? Metabolomics is the study of metabolites, and metabolites are the end products of metabolism. These are very small molecules, and collection of all these small molecules that are produced after metabolism in a cell is called as metabolome. And there are two approaches, targeted and untargeted approach. This comes under experimental design of the workflow, and targeted means specific metabolite is analyzed, while untargeted means many metabolites are analyzed from different or same biological sample. Since many metabolites are analyzed, this untargeted approach is also called as global approach. So the next workflow that will be coming is sample preparation, sample collection and preparation. Okay, the sample is collected from different biological samples like cells, blood, urine, and etc. Okay, and the next one is instrumental analysis. While here we use NMR and mass spectroscopy. And the next workflow that comes is the data acquisition and analysis. Here we use many softwares like Target Search and MZMine. And the next one is statistical analysis. We do that for to reduce the number of variables and to get our result, okay? And the next one is the network. Once we find which metabolite is the cause of the death, then we can also find which pathway produces this metabolite and how it has affected the individual. And here we can see the applications of metabolomics, that is drug discovery, disease metabolome, biomarker discovery and disease prediction, and many more. Coming to the main topic, methanol toxicity. Methanol is a very common compound, and we see them very, very commonly. So the formula is CH3OH. Methanol is also called as methyl alcohol or wood alcohol. It is a weak base compound, and it is present in all living organisms. Though it is a common suicidal agent, it is very rarely used as a murder agent. And once this methanol is ingested, it gets absorbed through gastrointestinal tract very rapidly, within 10 minutes. Remember, methanol itself is not toxic, but its metabolites, formaldehyde and formic acid, are the toxic ones. Coming to methanol metabolism, this picture shows the general mechanism of methanol metabolism. So methanol is oxidized by alcohol dehydrogenase in the liver and to form formaldehyde. This formaldehyde is later broken down by alcohol dehydrogenase to form formic acid. Though the methanol is present in all living organisms, that means there is a production of formic acid in a natural way. That is, there is also elimination takes place. While when the methanol concentration increases, the formic acid formed also increases. In this case, the formic acid accumulates easily. Once this formic acid accumulates, it inhibits cytochrome oxidase chain. This cytochrome oxidase chain is very important in electron transport, which produces ATP. Once this electron transport chain is hindered, the ATP production decreases. Thus, all these cell activities are disturbed. And this formic acid is also responsible for metabolic acidosis, retinal toxicity. If this situation is untreated, it might even lead to death. Coming to the signs and symptoms, the fatal dose of methanol is usually from 60 to 200 ml, and the fatal period is 24 to 36 hours. It may be delayed for 2 to 4 days, depending on the concentration of methanol ingested. The general symptoms include nausea, headache, drowsiness, vomiting, small respiration, that is distress respiration, neck stiffness, cyanosis, dilation of pupil, coma, and death. There is a presence of odor in breath, and also CNS is affected very intensely. You can see that the skin is bluish in color. This depicts the marked cyanosis. And the next one is retinal necrosis, where the white spot shows the part which is affected. And in severe cases, brain hemorrhages also can take place. So the case studies. Case number one, a 32-year-old individual was seen retching, in the sense making the sound of vomiting. A witness reported that the victim drank car washer solution by mistake, confusing it for alcohol. Soon after, the victim complained of headache and stomach ache. He was transferred to hospital and received a treatment in ICU, but he was reported dead after 20 days. In this case, the methanol concentration in blood was not analyzed. And the case number two, a 42-year-old male working in veterinary field was admitted to hospital due to vomiting and hematuria. It was found that the victim used to sanitize his hand with the unspecific substance, as well as unspecified amount of alcohol was ingested. He also had a history of addiction to cocaine. The victim died after 24 hours of admission due to cardiorespiratory arrest. The methanol concentration was determined in this case, and it was found about 79 mg per dL. Coming to the conclusion, though these two cases were an accidental death, if the same was the crime scene, the metabolomics will prove to be immensely helpful in accurately determining the actual cause of death. The death occurs due to metabolites of methanol. Determining the concentration of methanol alone will not be helpful since it can be easily metabolized, while determining the concentration of formic acid will definitely determine the degree of toxicity. Thank you.